Hey there, happy Wednesday. It is time for CEO check-in. I hope your week is off to a good start. Here in New York, it's getting a little bit chilly. We're still all eating outside in these restaurants, but last night I had on my little jacket, a scarf, gloves. We were having dinner with my mother, my two boys and I, and my mom, and she was like, can I borrow your gloves? And I was just thinking, I don't know how much longer all this is going to work, this eating outside. But we're gonna make it work as long as we can, because it's important to be able to see our friends and loved ones, even if we can't have them in our homes. Anyway, I hope you're having a good week. I hope that back to school is going well. If you have kids, my kids are each kind of in half back to school, half working at home, so we're making that work. And today I'm super excited about our guest because she is a former coaching client of mine. She's a rock star marketer. She's gonna be calling in from Colorado, so we'll get to hear how things are going out there. And she's gonna be sharing some really great marketing tips. She wrote this book, Change, Adapt, Rock, and it's the secrets and tips of her company, Wild Rock Public Relations and Marketing, to help small businesses with their marketing. So what better timing than right now when we are in Q4 and trying to figure out how we can go big this year, even though it's such a weird year. We still can be making more money, reaching more clients, signing up more customers, and Kristen's gonna help us with all that today. Hey Lori, hi Rabia, hi Rosemary, so nice to see friends coming on here. And I am gonna leave a little time at the end for live coaching because I think a lot of great things are gonna come up today with Kristen and you guys might have some questions about that. So we'll make sure to leave some time at the end for live coaching. So stick around. Before Kristen comes on, I just wanna share my go big tip today. So the go big tip today is to be a thought leader. And what that means is to really focus part of your time and energy every single week on figuring out how you can share some of your expertise with your future customers and your current customers. So how can you be a thought leader? Even if you don't have a book out like I do, or you're not preparing a TED talk, right? Those are some of the big thought leader things that we see people do. But you can also just start a live like this, right? This is part of thought leadership. You can make time to blog. You can do posts on LinkedIn and social media. You can write a blog post and then push that out through your social media. There are so many ways, and Kristen actually is gonna help us with that today, of becoming a thought leader. And I do see that the women who are really serious about going big, they make time for this and they make it a priority so that people know that they are different from the other people in their field who are followers. You wanna position yourself as a leader in your field. And part of that is making time to be a thought leader and put your ideas out there where people can get to know you, see what you're all about, and sample a little bit of your secret sauce before they come in to work with you. All right, so with that being said, we're gonna bring on Kristen. I'm so excited to see her. And here we go. Welcome, Kristen Gallagher. We're gonna let the internet do its thing. Hey there.
It is. Hello, Julia. Hi. How are you?
I'm great. How are you today?
I'm doing well.
Awesome. How are things in Colorado? What's going on out there?
Okay, so we are in a little bit of a smoky environment today.
I don't know if you can tell
out my window, but we have some crazy forest fires. So, you know, hello 2020.
I'm so sorry. I know I've been following all that. And are you able to like go outside or do you have to stay in?
No, I mean, you know, thank goodness I'm working today, so it's a good excuse to be like, oh, well, I can't go outside because I have to work today. But yeah, it's nasty out, but hopefully it'll clear soon.
Are the kids in school or are they doing it from home?
A little bit of both. So a lot like your kiddos where they have some in person and some virtual. So thank goodness for my awesome nanny.
Thank goodness. So you can be here with us. So thank you.
Exactly.
We're really excited for you to share some of your tips with us. And, you know, before we dive in, you have so many great pearls in this book, which is available. Where is this available? People get this on your website, right?
On Amazon, yeah.
So on Amazon, okay.
Our website, right. But you can get it on Amazon.
Yes, and this is hot off the presses. I just read this a couple of weeks ago. But it's a really great guidebook for any small business to figure out all the pieces of marketing, from SEM, SEO, to writing a press release, to figuring out how to put great content out there, right? Yeah. The thought leadership that we'll come back to. But before we dive into all that, can you just tell everyone a bit of your background and how you started Wild Rock PR and Marketing?
Sure. So I actually started my career on the agency side and then went in-house full-time after I graduated from college with Otterbox. So I helped start their PR and marketing department. So if anybody has Otterboxes on their phones, I
I
started
do
in the
right
early
now, funny
days.
enough. I have an Otterbox case
I
on
love
right now,
it.
so thank you.
Yay. So a small little Fort Collins, Colorado company that literally grew overnight. So it was incredible to be a part of that ride. But I had that entrepreneurial bug and I couldn't fight it. And so I went and told the CEO that I was leaving and he just got this big grin and he's like, yeah, I knew you'd do this. So I was dragging my feet because I love my job. I loved the people that worked with me, but I was just seeking something a little bit different. So spun out in 2012 and started Wild Rock
I
and
love it.
haven't
Did
looked
you
back.
have like early inklings of your entrepreneurial leanings, like when you were in, elementary school or high
Oh
school?
yeah. Yeah. In fact, I was totally in denial about it, but as I've talked with like friends and family, they're like, "How did you not realize you've always been an entrepreneur? Like you had the cookie bake sales and you were raising money to build forts and walking people's dogs and going door to door asking if you could watch people's kids with like a backpack of fun things to do." So apparently
I
I
love
was
it. I
lucky
know. I
enough
love
that
hearing how other people came to entrepreneurship because sometimes people around you know it before you do, right? Where it's
Oh,
like,
totally.
yeah, go start your own company. Do it.
Yep.
Well, yes. And when I got to know you when we were doing our coaching engagement together, you're so beloved by your team. You're such an amazing leader. You have really big, awesome clients. And I'm just so thrilled that you guys decided to share some of what's been working with in your company for, small and big clients and bring it to small business owners so they can start to implement some of this great stuff. So thank you for
Yep.
doing that.
Yeah. Well, and that was kind of the challenge to the team, right? I mean, when this whole pandemic hit, we're all working from home, or those of us who have kids are trying to do the homeschool thing and, run our businesses and things like that. But I really put the challenge back to the team with the book. And I was like, guys, how do we help these small businesses? And, what if we just gave them everything? And so that's really what the book is like we reveal templates, we reveal checklists, rock star tips. So, it's kind of the full gamut if you're really looking to level up your business. And as we're at the tail end of this crazy year, what better time than to kind of reevaluate marketing efforts overall?
Yeah, and I would be curious just because I think a lot of people watching are also, coming up with new ideas, trying to figure
Yeah.
out new things. What else did you consider? Like, how did you get to the place where you're like, let's do a really affordable book? Because it's like $15, right? The book, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like super affordable. What did you consider and throw out? Just share with us a little bit of the process.
Oh man. Okay. Well, yeah, I mean the typical, entrepreneur roller coaster is so it started with like a 5-page ebook that quickly like escalated into a larger ebook that was then like let's share templates that then became okay, let's do a paperback. So, I mean, it was the full gamut in terms of going through that process that just grew and grew and grew. And so, the cool part is now we're able to share those ideas with the world. And specifically, if people are like, I don't really want to work with an agency, I can do this on my own, or, I already have a staff that's perfectly capable to do some of these marketing efforts. This is just kind of that way to give them a little bit of the push from the nest, so to speak, so that it encourages them that, they can do it on their own.
I love that. And the truth is, with marketing, people often feel like it's sort of the Grand Canyon. Like, where do I start? There's so
Yeah.
many different things to do. I often hear from women, I don't even know what I don't know, right? In marketing,
Right.
like Facebook ads, how do you do that? So, how did you guys decide on what you put in here? Because you have, really covered a lot. What are these things that you've been seeing are the crucial things, like when you're working with the bigger companies? And I'll just read for the sake of people listening. They
Yeah.
cover marketing strategy, public relations, digital marketing, content, social media, crisis communications, conclusion. Well, conclusion has a bunch of other stuff in it, but that's like a lot right there, right?
It's a
Marketing,
lot.
PR, digital marketing, content, social media, crisis communications. Why those five things?
Yeah.
Six things.
Well, I'll start with the end one, right? Which is crisis communications. And that's like a very obvious thing. During the pandemic, people were coming to us like, I need a crisis communications plan. I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing internally with my employees or externally, with people. You were mentioning restaurants, Julia, earlier. And it's like, how do I get customers into my restaurant so that they feel safe? So it was a lot of those kinds of things. And so that's actually where we started, was with the crisis side of things. Like, how do we help people through a crisis and how to navigate a pandemic. But yeah, I mean, all of the other ones are just basic building blocks to marketing and public relations and digital marketing. In some of those chapters too, specifically digital, because you're right, a lot of people are like, wow, like I have a Facebook account, but I don't know how to run a Facebook ad. Some things aren't as scary. And then some things are like, yeah, you're going to want to leave that to the experts. So in some cases, we even ranked the level of difficulty. So if you're more advanced in marketing, there are absolutely things you can start to take on your own. And if you've never touched it before, it's a great opportunity to then delegate that out, you know, whether it's to an intern or an agency or someone internally who might be a little bit more digital, you know.
Well, and I have to say, you can really tell reading the book that it was written by someone who's been there herself, right? Because as CEOs, we're always trying to figure out, is this something I have to do? Is this something I can have a junior person on my team do? Or do I need to outsource it to professionals? Right.
Well, and I think that was, you know, one of the tips that you gave me too, Julia, in our coaching time together was like, you know, entrepreneurs are the ultimate, you know, let me take on everything and let me own everything and I'll figure it out and I'll navigate it. And we're bulls in a china cabinet. Like we don't know how to do it all the time and we don't always do it the best. And so I think the same lens can be taken with marketing.
And we don't love doing it all either, right? No. We do things that we're not even that good at and don't love doing. So why aren't we just outsourcing them? What's one thing that you started handing off that you didn't used to hand off? I think that would help people to understand what they might be able to hand off too.
Yeah, no, I mean, the book itself, I mean, we didn't do any of the cover design. We didn't do any of the internal design. We've been slammed with other client projects. And so it was like, okay, we want to get this book to market and we want to help these small businesses. But that was the first to go. I mean, I can tell you what a good cover looks like, but I can't design it. So it was like, okay, we got to outsource that. We got to delegate, you know, some of those pieces to people who actually specialize in cover design or specialize.
That was so smart, right? And then you got it done. You know, we always say, you know, if you want to get it done, outsource it, right? Because if you pay someone, they'll do it and then you can check it off your list. Well, and I know that you were talking about doing a book when we first started working together. I think it was a couple of years ago. And, you know, what made you decide that this was a thought leadership piece for you that was worth investing time, energy, and resources in, since I kind of launched that topic today with the Go Big Tip?
Yeah, I mean, the thought leadership component is huge. And, you know, we do mention parts of that in the book as well. But for us in particular, it's proven to be a thought leadership piece after the fact. So we didn't set out with it, you know, needing or wanting to be something that, you know, would position Wild Rock in a different way. It was, you know, sheerly, how do we help these small businesses that are struggling and suffering and maybe can't afford an agency like Wild Rock, but still want to be engaging in marketing efforts? And so as the idea then evolved and grew, it was like, oh, wow, this could be really cool for us too. And so that's why the author is Wild Rock. It's not Kristen. You know, it's not one particular person on the team, it's us as a team, and it's pooling all of those ideas and resources together. So, you know, thought leadership for all of us at the agency is amazing now that we have this book out there and we can speak to it, or if people come to us and they're like, you know, hey, I want to do this and I have this kind of budget, we can easily direct them to the book. So it just, it adds a different layer to our organization that we didn't have previously.
What kinds of things are happening since the book came out? Like, are people calling, wanting to have sessions with you? Or like, tell us a little bit what it's been like since it was released.
Yeah, well, like this, like, you know, an Instagram live. I mean, it was so great. I was like, I don't know what I'm doing on this. Like, I tell clients how to do this all the time, but
You were a quick study, though. I think you got trained 2 days ago.
Oh, yeah,
you're like, okay, now you're going live.
But yeah, but I mean, it's opportunities like this that, you know, wouldn't traditionally be coming our way. You know, we're looking at other thought leadership pieces through different, you know, magazines. We've had PR write-ups that have happened as a result of this. We've been asked to be guest bloggers through, you know, professional organizations. So it's just, it's interesting. It's like, we do public relations for clients all the time, you know, but then doing it for ourselves is like, it's totally different. We've never even marketed an author before. And here we are marketing ourselves as authors. So,
well, and I hear this so much from marketing agencies that, you know, they just spend all their time promoting other people. And then sometimes, you know, their kids are the cobbler's kids with the worst shoes, right?
Totally.
Where they're like, I keep meaning to put testimonials on my website, but I haven't gotten there yet. So good for you for making this a priority and doing exactly what we've been talking about doing in our community since day one of the pandemic, which is, you know, look for the new problems that your customers have, right? Because maybe some of your old customers were shut down or didn't have the budget anymore, or things were frozen. And, you know, as entrepreneurs, we're just problem solvers, right? So you took a look around and said, hey, wait, there's all these small businesses who still have to market, and in fact, have to market in this 100% digital environment that they may or may not really be ready for. So how can we create an affordable, you know, book that, by the way, will also double as thought leadership to help them with that problem, right? Be a problem solver. And now that's leading to new clients. Give us a little sense, like, is there like a steady flow coming in? Because I think people listening are probably wondering, well, gosh, to write a book, that would take a long time. Like, what's really the payoff? Let's hear a bit about that.
Well, we went to market very quickly with it. So, you know, in typical Kristen speed, so it wasn't just like, okay, this is going to be a 3-year process. It was like, nope, we need to streamline that. Let's do it in 3 months. So
yeah, you banged this out. This was, oh my gosh. But you have a great team too, as you were talking about.
Oh, my team. I mean, they're incredible. So, you know, when I brought the idea to the table, it was kind of like, okay, we're going to do this, and we're going to do it at warp speed, because the community needs it. Businesses need this. We need to bring this to market. So, you know, I think that was, you know, the challenging part is getting it to market so quickly. And this next evolution is, what do we do with the book? And so we've used it in some really different ways. Like, we actually, and I'll have to keep you posted. We just sent out a batch of them as a business development opportunity. So we had a lot of leads in the pipeline, people who had to cancel things maybe in that March timeframe when the pandemic first hit. So we just sent out a handful of books. We earmarked pages that we thought would be helpful, or topics we were talking about with that organization that were like, hey, we were discussing digital marketing back in March. And, you know, are there—
Oh, what a great idea. I love that.
So we're using it as a business development tool. And our cost for the book is far less than the business development packets we were putting together initially. And so that's kind of an interesting way to look at it too, is like, how do you use it as a biz dev tool? And then what were you paying to put together packets and mailers and things like that initially?
Well, and let's also be transparent about the fact that you've built these great productized services, because we talk about this a lot in our community at Million Dollar Women. Women who have services businesses are often told, you know, it's going to be really hard to scale because you have a services business. Yeah. And so one thing you and I worked on a lot in our coaching time together was, how do you turn your agency into one where you have really clear packages? And do you think now, having the book, these two are going to work hand in hand? And I know that's a leading question, but
it is, but it's such a good one, because you look at the chapters, going back to your other question, you look at the chapters and it actually breaks down all those services by those packages. So if you want strategy, then here's the strategic services we offer. If you want PR, here's the PR services. So, I mean, the productizing position for Wild Rock has been a game changer. And thank you for helping us with that, because I don't know that we would have seen the business in that light had it not been for you kind of shining a light on it and bringing that to our attention, Julia.
Well, I love it, because this is really the natural evolution of that process, in the sense when you were saying a few minutes ago, you know, the book doesn't say, you know, Kristen Galler, right? It says Wild Rock Public Relations and Marketing. And this is exactly what we want women to do, is not build the business around their, you know, persona, because then everyone always wants you, right? I mean, the beauty of your brilliance with this company is that you've empowered your team, you've hired great people, you treat them amazing, they love you. I know that from our work together. And now you've created this kind of rainmaking thought leadership piece, which, you know, some entrepreneurs listening might be thinking, well, whoa, if I did a book and all these people started contacting me, I'd be so quickly overwhelmed, right? But you're not overwhelmed. You're sitting here talking with us because you don't have to deliver all these services, right? Yeah. So maybe tell us a little bit about that for people who are first hearing this term, like productizing your services. Like, what are you talking about?
So it's, I mean, it's basically having set packages of, this is exactly what we do and here's what we offer. And then my team doesn't have to think through it each time either. So we have a lot of systems and processes that kind of overlay that piece too. So they know exactly what to deliver each time. And it's consistent for the team internally. And more importantly, it's consistent for the client externally. So they're getting the same thing. We're generating results for them. We're seeing businesses grow, you know, literally overnight with some of the efforts that we're doing. So that part is just super cool to see.
How is that different from how you were before? Like, if someone's listening well, wait, isn't that just running a company? What were you doing before?
Oh yeah, no, it was anything that you want, right? So my internal joke was like, okay, well, walk your dog, wash your car, watch your kids, and oh, by the way, maybe do your PR and marketing. So
so whatever people came to you with, you just said yes. It was just yes, yes, yes.
Oh, 100%. Yeah, it was like, whatever you need, like, yes, we'll do it. Here, sign the contract.
And so what's the downside of that? Spell it out for us.
Oh gosh. Well, the downside of it is you just constantly spin your wheels. And, for some clients, you're on budget. For other clients, you're just over servicing them all the time because, there's no clarity in terms of exactly what you're offering. And you're just a free for all. You're like, okay, you want an e-newsletter? Sure, we'll throw that in there. I mean, it's just all over the map. And so this provides clarity for the client. It provides consistency for my team, and just allows us to do better work with less stress because there's the processes behind the scenes that it's like, okay, I'm stuck at step three. What's next? And then, here's some tips on how to move on to step four. So
100%. And I would
that
also
whole
add to that
revolution.
that it really elevates you as a thought leader because you become expert in these four or five things that you're delivering over and over again, and you become known for those, right? Instead of like, oh, she can also, wash my car and do
Right.
the babysitting. Right?
Yeah.
Like you probably couldn't have even written this book, I imagine, if you hadn't sort of picked those areas and said, hey,
Yeah.
we're experts in these things.
Yep. And you're totally spot on, Julie. I mean, there'd be no way we could pull that book together if we hadn't had those systems and processes, as well as, being very clear about who we are and who we aren't, because this is a totally different line, right? This is a product that we're now like officially selling. And so we had to kind of navigate that and learn that and figure out, Amazon algorithms and everything else that kind of went with that,
I know, I love how you just dove right into this. You're like, we've never done a book before, but we're gonna
No.
figure it out as we go, which is awesome. And then you can also help, some of your clients with that. I know people may have questions, so I wanna give
Yeah.
everyone a chance to see if there are questions. I see a lot of women from our community, Rosemary Day, who wrote an amazing book, Marching Towards Coverage about women in healthcare. She runs a marketing agency in Boston. Rabia is on, Marion. So I want to see Lori. If you have questions, put them in the chat. There's a little delay, so I'll give it a minute. And
Okay.
I would love to hear from you, since I know you now have small business owners calling you from around the country who've read the book and want additional support. What are one or two of the things you're hearing most often? What do people want help with? Is it content creation? Is it social media? Is it getting PR? What are you hearing the most right now, Kristen?
I think PR is still one of the most confusing services kind of within that marketing umbrella. Our internal joke is, did I lose you between the P or the R? People are like, we don't know what it is. So, public relations, the way that we define it here, is really getting your story out. And so that can mean getting your story out to the media, like a traditional outlet, like a TV or a magazine or radio station, but it can also be these unique outlets too, right? Like, could you be a guest blogger? Could you contribute something through a podcast or something of that nature? So I think it's exploring PR in some different ways that it may not be the traditional media that people are used to. Newsrooms unfortunately are shrinking, and so what that means is creating these deep-seated relationships with journalists. And at the end of the day, they're people. So how are you serving up on a silver platter this amazing story where you've polished and you've buttoned everything, and they can just turn and run it? A lot of what's going on in the news right now is negative. And so how are you serving up these positive news stories? What's the growth in your business, or what's something cool or innovative that you're offering that nobody else does? So,
And I know you
PR
teach
seems to
that in the
be.
book because I think you said you had like low or no cost
Yeah,
PR, right?
yes, there are so
Yeah.
many ideas that, like, it's not going to cost you a penny. I mean, it's going to cost you your time, and time is money. So there's great ways to delegate and outsource that. But if you have time to dedicate to PR, there can be tremendous ROI on that, by
And
doing some
one
of these free
piece, right, could
ideas.
lead to thousands of new
Yeah,
hits, clients,
yes.
et cetera. Yeah, no, I mean, PR is like, I always like to say, it's the best advertising that money can't buy, right?
Yes.
Because you can buy, social media, SEM, but once you get the PR hit, it's like the
Yep.
floodgates can really open depending where. We have one graduate of our program who got in with a podcast, and
Nice.
something like 90% of her clients come from people who heard her on the podcast. And it's not even her podcast. She's just interviewed on it on a
Yeah.
regular basis. Okay, so here's a question from Rosemary Day. How do you help clients prioritize and keep from being overwhelmed by all of the content marketing avenues and possibilities? I'm sure lots of people have that.
Yes.
Same question. How do you help clients prioritize and keep from being overwhelmed by all of the content marketing avenues and possibilities?
Yeah, Rosemary, I love that question because it's very easy to be overwhelmed by all the different avenues that you can go with content marketing. But I would say actually go back to your target audience. So what might be an important content marketing piece to you, like you might think, oh, I love blogs, but your target audience is reading something different or engaging in a different way. So I think there's really great opportunities to actually dive into your target market differently and almost doing like a persona analysis, right? Like, who are they? What do they do? What do they read? Where do they live? What do they do on the weekends? I mean, there's really great ways to kind of dive into those target audiences to better understand them. And then you can prioritize those content marketing pieces that are actually going to reach them. So remove yourself from the equation. It's not about you. It's not about what's important to you or your boss, or if you are the CEO, you know, you can't get territorial over it. It's what's important to your target market at the end of the day and what's gonna cause them to, you know, do some kind of action, work with you or sign up for something or something of that nature. So
I like that. And do you suggest that people have like one main place they're the most active and then the other ones can be sort of secondary, or do you recommend that people really try to be on all these platforms, right? Social media and blogging and podcasting and doing live videos.
Yeah.
It's exhausting.
I think it's better to do fewer things and do them at 100% than to try to do like everything at a 10% effort when you're like, oh man, I'm so scattered. I don't have time and energy to do all of these things. And sometimes it's sitting down and planning for that. Like if you've got a Facebook and an Instagram, you might have to sit down once a month and be like, what am I actually going to do this coming month? And then you sit down one day versus every single day being like, I don't know what I'm going to do today. So planning.
And having great systems. I know you have great systems at Wild Rock PR and Marketing. You know, we have a shared Google spreadsheet and my team that is shared by multiple people who do social media and planning on my team. And we have a call every week where we go over it. So do you have any systems that you love that someone listening could implement or look into?
Yeah, I mean, I think those content planning components, and there's a ton of ways to do that, whether it's through Google Docs or Dropbox or, you know, some internal sharing system. So you can jot those ideas down as you have them. So with much of us in that entrepreneurial realm, you'll have an idea and it's like, oh, that was a thought in the shower. Now it's a fleeting thought. And I can't remember what that great idea was. And so
you'll have a place to park that, right? Until you can do something with it is essential.
Yeah. And then being able to bounce those ideas off your team. So sometimes you'll have a starting place and somebody else on your team can, you know, iterate that to the next level and it just keeps going and growing. So yeah, I mean, establishing some kind of routine to content is also a great way to manage that and make sure it's not all over the map and you're clear and true to your brand and, you know, you're on point with those messages and it's not last minute and scattered. It shouldn't be stressful.
That's a good point. Right. It shouldn't be stressful. And then also you can start to see what are the things I love to do that I want to sort of be more involved with.
Yes.
And then what can I outsource? And then also to track like what is converting, right? Am I actually getting clients from these things? And let's double down on those things. What do you find people want to outsource first? Like in your small business owners you work with, what's the first thing that they tend to outsource that you've seen them have success with? Is it blog writing? Is it social media? Is it PR?
Yeah, I think probably as of late, it's the social media side of things because it moves so quickly. So, you know, even on our team, as we're managing those social accounts, somebody's always looking at things. So, I mean, you know, those crazy comments will come in at 11 p.m. at night and it's like, oh my gosh, who's going to manage that? And so I think small businesses especially are like, I don't want to have to be in charge of that. It's a 24/7 game. If you dip your toe in the water, like you're in, you're committed. You can't back out at that point. So having, you know, an agency to help with that or having a person on your team who's responsible for social media all the time, make sure that it moves and it's seamless and that ultimately the person on the other end is getting that engagement, they're getting reactions and things of that nature versus just having a comment set out there for weeks and you know, the CEO goes and looks and like, oh, I missed that. Now the whole conversation's gone downhill. So
totally. Or just being inconsistent, like you were talking about before, like sometimes you post, sometimes you don't, right? I think once you outsource it, you get into a rhythm where you have to be more consistent.
Yep.
This is all so helpful. I'd be curious where you guys are going next at Wild Rock PR and Marketing. Like what are the next few months look like for you? Let's think big picture a minute. Go big. CEO check-in. Yeah.
So yesterday we did this amazing team build and we talked about inventions and hopefully this will spark some inspiration for people because it sure did for my team. So basically we all went and did our little homework and we brought back an invention, something that makes our life easier. And the end result is hopefully coming up with some new ideas and inventions for Wild Rock that are kind of outside the box. And so everybody brought back some different things. Mine, for example, was the Keurig coffee maker because I'm a coffee addict, but I'm the only one in my house that drinks it. And so, you know, it's an easy way to get a cup of coffee, right? And it's inspiring to see how some of these ideas transpire from trying to solve a problem. So with Keurig in general, that problem was solved by two gentlemen, one of which quit his, you know, high-paying IT job and went to create this amazing product that was going to solve a problem in an office space. So typical office coffee is like nasty and bitter and it sits on a warmer all day, but this allows you to create a fresh
and not customized, right? You also solve that you could have your own kind, right? Decaf or hazelnut or whatever.
Totally. 500 varieties of Keurig options out there.
So I didn't know that.
We don't work for Keurig. I have no personal, you know.
No, but this is a great example. Keep talking to them because this is really interesting.
I love them. So 500 options now. But basically, they had targeted what they thought was going to be a B2B only market with offices. And now it's the number one seller for consumers because we all want our individual coffee pods and we want to be able to customize that or grab a cup, you know, on the way out the door, as any of us, you know, who have kids know that you're always on the go and things like that. So it was cool to see a lot of different personalities come out on the team and people bring different inventions to the table. And you're like, wow,
what a fun exercise. I love that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's so great. Cool. And by the way, the fact that you just did create a new product, right? Your book, Change, yes. Adapt, Rock, for anybody who's just joining us. This is a great marketing book for small business owners to rock their marketing, available on Amazon. The fact that you just had this great experience with, hey, let's try something new and do a book, and it's led to all these great things already. Do you think that helped to energize your team and think about, okay, well, now let's come up with the next cool thing out of the box?
Yep. Yeah, or how do we iterate from the book, right? Mm. So it's like, okay, the book is now launched. And how do we take these other, you know, concepts or ideas and bring these new innovations to them? So, you know, with any new business idea, you don't have to be the one that comes up with the main idea. It's how do you make it better? And yes. How do you, you know, bring those things to life? So it was really inspiring. So 2021, I mean, man, we need to put a bow on this year. It's been a great year for Wild Rock, but I think
but we're ready to move
stuff,
on from
I'm
this
like,
year.
Yeah.
Although, yeah, I saw some funny meme about like, why is it that we think 2021 is going to like embrace us with big warm arms? Like so far, it doesn't seem to be on track to be that much different than
it's
2020.
Not.
But I love how you guys are kind of making your own magic internally. Like, okay, we can't control what's out there, but let's do these really fun exercises. And that exercise you did, by the way, is really doing one of the key things a CEO is supposed to do. Because sometimes we think, oh, as a CEO, I'm supposed to have all the answers. But that's not true. We're just supposed to ask the right questions. So you were asking the right questions to your team, right? Like, what inventions do you love? What else can we invent? Let's get this going as a dialogue. So I love that you did that.
Yeah, it was really fun and hopefully inspires others because there's so many cool things out there. And as you do research on it, you're like, you know, I could take something similar into my business and apply that. Or like I said earlier, other ideas come to mind or people can iterate. So
thank you for sharing that example. And we've been talking a lot in our community just about problem solving, because when we feel too overwhelmed, like the world's going bananas and maybe you're in travel or sports or entertainment or the food business and everything has changed, right? And you're not sure when it's coming back. If we can go back to that basic principle of we're problem solvers. People still have problems. They might be new problems, right? But how do we solve those problems? And that's exactly what you and your team were doing. So Kristen, thank you so much for coming on. I'm so grateful. Thanks for writing the book. Thank you for all the small businesses that you have helped and are going to continue to help. And I'm just so excited to see what you guys are going to invent in 2021.
Yay. Awesome. Well, thank you so much again for having me. I really appreciate it.
My pleasure. Where can people find you? Where do you like to post? Like, where can they come find you on social media?
Oh, so they can find us on all the Wild Rock social media channels. So we have Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, and then we also have new channels for Change Adapt Rock. And those are completely a different brand. We have a blast on those. So go check out the latest meme on there. It's an Austin Powers reference, if anybody's seen Austin Powers.
So fun. Yep, that's my generation.
Good.
So they'll find you at Wild Rock, right? And then that can lead them over to the new Change Adapt Rock as well.
Yes.
Awesome. And you're getting big love from our community. So thank you so much for coming on. And I'm going to do a little live coaching. So stick around. I'm sure there'll be some fun stuff in there.
Awesome. Thanks so much.
Thanks, Kristen. Have a great day. Bye. Awesome. Oh, those were such good ideas about marketing and how you can start to fire up your thought leadership and create great content and get PR. These are all things that we all have to be doing right now, since traditional networking has gone away and we're just trying to get really creative about how to stay in front of our customers and attract our next customers and clients. So let me see if there's somebody who wants to go live and we can talk about thought leadership and what you're doing for thought leadership. I know there are people on this call who are already ramping that up. Rabia, you've been doing great videos on LinkedIn. Rosemary wrote her book. Rosemary Day wrote the book, Marching Towards Coverage, and is working with in healthcare marketing. And they do a lot of thought leadership on LinkedIn, on their website. So let's see who wants to go live. Lori, who runs a community in upstate New York for women entrepreneurs, has been putting great thought leadership out there. And hang on, I'm just getting a couple of requests. If you want to go live, you can just press the button that's right at the top and we will bring you on. Okay. I am going to, oh, no, this is not completely working. All right, so then we're going to wrap up because we had a great session with Kristen. We got really good tips. Change, Adapt, Rock is a book that can help you with your marketing. So check it out on Amazon. And thanks for joining us. I will see you next week right back here on CEO Check-In. Until then, stay brave and go big.